Hi, this is Sharon Maclis, Director of Editorial Data and Analytics at IDG Communications. I'm here with episode 4 of Do More With R, Build a Quick Dashboard. I'm going to show one of the easiest ways to create a dashboard in R using the Flex Dashboard package. First, you need to install it with the Install Packages command. Then, if you're using RStudio, you can create a document with a Flex Dashboard template. Go to File, New File, R Markdown, and you'll see an option to create a document from template. If you're not familiar with R Markdown, it's a way to mix text, graphics, and R code and create output like HTML or Word. Select from template, and there should be an option for Flex Dashboard. I'll make sure that's selected and click OK. This is the default template. That top header between the three dashes is in a format called YAML, Y-A-M-L. It's setting up the document output. This YAML says, make this R Markdown document a Flex Dashboard, set it up by columns, you can also set it up by rows, and have it fill the entire available browser space. This default template includes space for three charts. The first chart is in its own column showing a width of 650. Then, the next column with the dashes below it creates a second column with charts B and C at a width of 350. I'll click the Knit button to see what that looks like. The Knit command turns an R Markdown document into its final output format, in this case HTML. I need to save the file before it will knit, as you'll see. I'll save that to test.rmd. And you see what it will look like, although there's no data in here yet. You can see the dashboard is set up for one wider column with one chart A, and then one narrower column with chart B, and then chart C below it. Now I need to create the graphics. We'll close this. R code to create the charts and graphs goes inside these gray areas here. You create those R code block sections with three backticks, followed by the letter R, lowercase, in braces, and then three backticks to end. I'm going to start adding R code to my dashboard by loading some libraries I know I'll want. I'll also import some data from last year's Computer World IT salary survey that I've got in a spreadsheet. You can use any R libraries you want. I'm going to use RC Dimple for a bar chart and DT for a table. I'll also give the dashboard a title. See this little green triangle here at the top right of this code chunk? That's a Run This Chunk button. I can just run this code chunk by clicking. And the data is imported. I can take a look at that in RStudio by clicking the variable name, as usual. And you can see the data frame that I've imported. For chart A, I'll use RC Dimple to make a basic bar chart and also change the header to something besides chart A. You can see the Dimple code is fairly simple. Let me knit this. There's the bar chart. Because it's a Dimple JavaScript chart, I can hover over the bars and see the data underneath. Since this is a dashboard, it would be nice to have something graphical to highlight the latest salary number, and maybe show whether it's up or down from the prior year. Flex Dashboard's value box function creates that kind of a dashboard box. Let's close this and look at the next block of code. The first line of code here for my icon sets the arrow icon. If the first salary number is greater than the second one, I'd like to use Font Awesome's up arrow. Otherwise, I'll use the down arrow. And I realize that means if the salary stays exactly the same, it will still show a down arrow. I'm okay with that. After all, given inflation, if your salary stays the same, real purchasing power has gone down. The second line of code sets the color. Success if the salary's gone up, danger if the salary's gone down. Value Box includes a few built-in color names like success, danger, warning, and info. You can also use color names. This third line creates the value box. I used scales dollar for the salary value, so the number displays with a dollar sign and comma. I'll knit that so you can see what we've got so far. And there's my box with the salary, the up arrow, and the header. Let's close that and look at the last part, which is adding a table with the salaries, which I did with DT's data table function. That options equals list in the data table just removes the search box in pagination. There are only 6 rows in the table, so search and pagination would look kind of silly. I'll take a final look at the dashboard now. Knitting again. And there's the basic dashboard. There's a lot more you can do with these. Customizing the look, make them more interactive. If you pair a Flex dashboard with the R Shiny web framework, you can even pull data in real time. Here's one by RStudio showing package downloads from their CRAN mirror. RStudio has a lot more about Flex dashboards at rmarkdown.rstudio.com/flexdashboard. That's all for this episode. Thanks for watching. For more R tips, head to the More with R video page at bit.ly/morewithr. That's https://bit.ly/morewithr, all lowercase except for the R. So long.